Now, I want to show you, tell you about another, actually, I want to introduce Jason to tell you about another real-world example of a code-splitting success story. The next slide, Jason Bright from Media Beacon. Jason.
Thanks.
Please.
So I'm Jason Bright, and I'm founder of Media Beacon, and we're an enterprise digital asset management company. And we provide enterprise asset management to customers, which in general have more than 100 employees and have millions of files to distribute among those employees. And we decided to go with GWT as our interface technology for many reasons. I could talk about it for a while, but I think it's easier to show it. So if we jump to the Media Beacon server, we can log on, and you see that it's a widget-based interface that has literally hundreds of widgets which are available, and you can place all the widgets on the pages, and then you can share this workspace with different users, and we can do some really magical things with GWT, so I can do things like drag and drop, and I can hover and expand folders, and there is no flash on this page. So this allows you to do all the highly interactive things that you expect off the desktop in a simple web interface, and then search your metadata. And MediaBeacon is unique because it has strongly attached metadata that's written into the assets. So as the assets move, you know everything about them. Now, one of the things that we did is we put all these highly interactive widgets that have to be able to drag and drop and send message to each other. You'll see when I click on one, it updates the rest. So we're doing a lot of GWT magic between these individual widgets. And when I want to configure the interface, I literally have hundreds and hundreds of widgets to select from. In addition to that, we use Open Syndication and Open Social to get an even larger set. So let me grab one from Open Social, and I'll go on iGoogle for a second, grab an iGoogle widget. I use Google Docs a lot, so I'll just grab my gadget. I'll go click a link, grab the URL, copy it, and then go ahead and go into my syndication widget, and I'm going to paste it right in there. And as soon as that comes up, I can tell it that it's not supposed to have as much size as it thinks it wants. So I can, if my hand will stop shaking, I guess I am nervous. And I can say how large it's supposed to be, and then I can put save. Now, I'm happy with that, and I can bring that to a point of prominence up here. And then I can take my date search widget over there, and I can name it My Docs. Great. So now I have an interface that has both Open Social widgets and highly connected widgets. And now here's the problem. The problem was that this code base kept getting bigger and bigger because GWT let us go farther and farther and be more and more aggressive with what we could develop. And so if we go back to my slides, the problem was we got up to 1.5 meg before you saw the login screen. Because everything that had to be highly interactive and had to allow drag and drop and events passing between each other had to be part of that initial download. And so it got incredibly painful. And before you could see the login screen, most people would click away. And so when we put code splitting in, we were able to jump from this 1.5 meg to 109K compressed. So that's smaller than the logo next to the login window is. And we're not making the logo smaller, just so you know. All right, and so the great part is I was able to gain all of this improvement, and what's great is that I didn't have to work very hard for it, relatively speaking. So if you look at the next slide, you'll see that we added about 16 lines of code because our application is all based on widgets, and so the widgets know when to load. The widgets are part of context, and you switch from context to context. So we simply added a bunch of run asyncs, and we were able to gain 1.4 meg for 16 lines of code, which is a pretty great saving. So in summary, MediaBeacon is a real-world application. It had a very large number of functions that had to be interrelated. The widgets weren't on the screen at the same time. This is a real-world example where code splitting allowed us to deliver the functionality that we need without having the users have an unfortunate experience, and now they think it's really, really perky. So we're very proud of the code splitting, and we're very happy the fact that we didn't have to do much for it. And we think that that we chose GWT out of all the other industry standards, and we think that GWT has really, in an instant, made us an industry leader ahead of all the other products because of the toolkit we use. So thank you. Thanks very much, Bruce.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Excellent. Yes, thank you.
You bet.